Love to all.
Love one. Let love one. One.
Fast serve into the backhand does the trick for Chun Meng, playing boldly, getting right into the rally. As long as it's deep on the table, it will help her chances. Out of all the players that Mima Chan has beaten from the Chinese national team, Chun Meng again, undefeated record.
2-1.
Good shovel serve here, deception at the point of contact. Ball coming back into the net.
One, three.
So quality start here from world number three. Up 3-1 here. Her service game is not only iconic, but very dangerous. One of the most dangerous factors about Mima Ito is that she is so unpredictable. She's willing to do anything from side spin to chops to flat hits. Mid-rally strawberry and a backhand counter punch from behind the table. Mima hits it right into the body of Chun Meng. Watch how fast this is. There's the mid-rally shot. A little bit of side spin. Here's the backhand brushing, opening from Chun Meng, and countered back on the move right into the pocket.
Five, one.
The Mima streak continues at the first towel break. 5-1, still a long, long way to go. And as we've seen from the most experienced and most prepared players in the world, including, of course, world number one, Chun Meng, who's been so dominant, sometimes it takes a little time to settle in. After all, it's tough to find a practice partner that plays like Mima Ito, because no one really does play like Mima Ito.
6-1.
The shovel serve drifts just barely long, but the rotation, tough to read. Caught in between, Chun Meng slowly spins it into the net. To come
one
up from that
seven.
Position. Mima Chan's already quite low, but when the head goes below the table here, just to get the ball back into play, straight side spin there. Quick punch shot, the Mima punch. Nearly below the table anyway. And a short stroke from the forehand, just lifting the elbow to stay on top of the ball.
One, eight.
Well, we saw a 2-8 comeback from Fang Zhendong earlier today against Wang Chuqin, when he was down 1-2. 1-8, quite a ways to go for Chun Meng. Backhand carries just long. Trying to keep it deep on the table. Second point here for Chun Meng. Just a steady backhand spin shot. Back to the basics in many senses, but it's different always coming off the short pips, less rotation than Chun Meng is used to. Not to mention with Mima Chan's fast hitting game, a little change of pace from time to time can keep the opponent guessing. Scorpion tail sting. Spun to the short side, but Chun Meng holds her ground and blocks it back into play. Well played, acknowledged there by Mima Chan. Watch where Chun Meng waits patiently. Started to set up for the forehand. That's a quick recovery, really. Makes it look easy. Have to see the replay. Facial expression from Mima Chan. No question she didn't want to let that one go.
Three,
and a deep push sets up 7 game points for the player who's never beaten Chun Meng and has averaged less than 2 games per match.
Left.
I believe they were all best of 7, too, so that means less than half, less than 1/3 of the games, rather, up for grabs. We're won by Mima Chung. Rip on the backhand. Mima punch. Still, she's never beaten Chun Meng. A complete match and a service gift. Omiyage. Songge ta. That is a gift for Chun Meng. It's 1/3 of her total points in game number one. Now from this camera angle, or rather with Mima Chan on the top of the screen, it changes the perspective a bit, but you can see that Chun Meng, deep push, gets a slower spinny one, and then spins it back deep herself. Keeps Mima a little bit uncomfortable to really come down on top of the ball hard. Good parallel backhand. Not even right to the line, just the surprise factor high. This one deep, quick enough, driven low.
La four.
Just the opposite. The tables have turned, and the scoreboard with it. I mean, the table's the same, but the players have turned around it. That's how it goes every game.
One, four.
Takes a lot here for a point. And Mima Chan working to stay near the table. She's got the smaller wingspan of the two.
Let, 1-4.
So 0-4 down looks like a long way to go, but just 1 point already back within three. A little fortune off the top of the net. We've seen what happens in doubles. Despite being a doubles champion in mixed doubles, Mima Chan with Junmi Zutani. What's coming out of Mima Chan's backhand? Out of the touch shot, falls just short. After a bit of a streak, 2 points in a row for Mima Chan. Chun Meng takes back control, steps into a 3-point lead once again. Quality long push, but Chun Meng adjusts quickly, gets ready, makes a quick backhand. And a shovel serve here, the kick. It's the sting of the scorpion tail. There's so many different ways that Mima Ito can present her serves. While the rotation on the ball might be similar, the placement, still the delivery.
Let.
Makes a big difference in terms of the receiver's eye and how they see the contact or how they at least see the serve coming in. A lot of work here for 1 point, chasing from behind the table. Chun Meng keeps the ball in play for some time, and Mima Chan on top of the bounce for the angles. In the forehand corner on the parallel, then the other way. This is her timing. Ball was maybe 2/3 of the way to its peak when she caught that last one.
Interesting.
The rotation, the specifics on it. We see mostly side spin. It's tough to tell what else is on it. Maybe at the towel break, we'll see a slow motion replay of that. You never know. Always interesting to see the details of what Mima Chan is doing. Perfectly handled this time. Once again, 2 shots in a row. We get a similar ball out of Mima Ito's backhand. Take another look here. Mostly underspin on the pendulum serve. I'm going to call that a banana split. Just a little bit under the ball as she drives still forward. Shocked moment here. The ball doesn't come down. The pressure comes back strong from Chun Meng.
Let, 5-7.
Checking the tension on the net there. Oh, back edge of the table for Chun Meng. bit of an escape after reaching out to cover the wide backhand. But I will say that Chun Meng, even when she appears to be out of position, regains balance. Her core strength is so, so great. A flatter shot. Mima punch down the line, brings her back within two. Now, the score line in game one reminded me of her score line in 2018 against Zhu Yuling in the final of the Swedish Open. Holding Zhu Yuling to less than 5 points average in four games straight. But what makes Chun Meng so dominant is her ability to adapt. One of many things, actually. That was an outstanding point. The chop blocks don't get much better. Mima Ito takes all the pace off it. Side spin with a bit of under, it appeared. And Chun Meng with the perfect touch right back. There it is, straight side. Chun Meng recovers the net ball there. Ito going for the kill. Three-point lead.
Please, you are wasting time. Play.
Fair enough. Strawberry comes out to play, and the first time we see it, it's effective out here. Strawberry, because it's the opposite side spin of the banana flick, or Chiquita, as Japan ever so dearly nicknamed it. Not easy to do. Pull up at the wrist, leave the fingertips down, the head of the racket. Chun Meng sort of shadow rehearsing it herself and how to respond.
No! 17.
That was a close one, I think, right here. This is a ball that Mima converts at a quite high percentage. That ball comes into play. Chun Meng is going to have some trouble keeping the racket open and countering back, but it's 3 game points for world number one, and the oyster shell is here.
No!
Two in a row for Mima, John. Fans in stadium and around the world tied up at 1 game apiece in the women's singles final. Chun Meng with the serve.
One love.
A good steady backhand from Chun Meng. Able to create the point she wants, earn that third ball attack. Much like her service game, Mima Ito spends half of the time on receive, so she's used to being quite creative there too. But that serve is as fast as can be, and even with the step around and the quick footwork and reaction time of Mima Chan, serve was just too fast and deep. It was exactly what Chun Meng wanted. Shots for 1 point, but this was a question of legs. Mima had her legs taken out from her throughout this rally. She was on the chase, never really was able to power back. Just a difference in pace right here, a little more passive play for Mima Chan. I think at one point in that ever so long rally, did she really just sort of spring forward? There we go, that's the Mima punch. That's the Mima punch that's given the Chinese national team a lot to worry about. A lot to train against and prepare for. Again, for the start of this game, it's been shut down pretty much. Chun Meng has kept Mima a little bit slower and more passive, more responsive. And right now, the off-speed side spin balls are not causing Chun Meng problems. She's in position near the table, and it just buys her a little bit more time. If she can read it, she knows what to do, and she can read it right now. Ah, well, the placement on this one, still off speed, but Mima moves in, takes the ball off the bounce, and plays it deep to the corner. Coach Mott's in the corner saying, stay cool, relax, no problem. It's tough to remind yourself sometimes after such a dominant game one and not quite the answers you're looking for in game two or the start of game three, to remind yourself that you're still in control. Maybe not fully, but having any control, you can only take care of what you can take care of. Worrying about the rest is energy not well spent. Easier said than done, of course. Within 1 point, Mima Chan on her second serve here. Right off the bounce, the timing and the placement. Chun Meng in form right now. I mean, we know this. The way she played 2019, one right down the line on the backhand, and before the ball rises, a page out of the Mima Ito textbook.
Let. 5-3.
Banana split comes back into the net, as you might expect it to, under and side spin from that backhand. But it was a let. No point. Not exactly what was in, not exactly sure what was in the crowd, was looking down just to see. It's interesting watching the knees of Mima Chan on the receive. See a little wiggling in and out there. Constant shifting. Look familiar? Wait till Chun Meng's back on this side of the table. Chun Meng and Zhu Yuling, we've seen do this quite a bit. Liu Shiwen as well, several of the top Chinese women. Oh, the counter back just within reach. That tiny wingspan reaches out and crushes the ball back to the open table. Being controlled, woman handled here, and flat hit back with a bit of side spin on it. Just out of reach, what creativity. From behind the table nonetheless, that's no Mima zone. Four serving six.
4-7.
Quickly coming back to return the tide here, to return the favor rather. It's amazing in terms, I often talk about scar power. How a point is worth 1 point, but sometimes it ends up costing an opponent more.
8-4.
I think we've all seen points like that where someone thought they clearly should have won the point and then they lose another few really quickly. The number one point, 2017, with Koki Niwa versus Fang Bo. Is that a sheep? A lamb? I think it's one of the two. Come on. Who brought the farm here? Cute farm, though. 8-4. Short stroke, good coverage of the middle. Much like Liu Shiwen, Mima Ito, as a smaller player, does have a smaller middle. Different physicalities, have to work hard for different reasons to play to their advantages. Smaller players tend to be quicker, more compact in their strokes. Quick footwork. Beautiful counter once again. Now, you wouldn't imagine in general that Mima Chan would be intentionally allowing Chun Meng the first ball just to counter back. But that stroke is so short, it comes in fast, just a little bit guiding motion forward, and the placement is perfect. Again, the ball's pretty light. If it comes in quickly, it's going to come out quickly as well. Especially if there's top spin on it. In trouble here, no timeout called yet. Ma Lin saying, do we? Nope, I think he's gonna save. Chun Meng just checking to see. There would be a timeout. Three in a row for Mima Chan. From behind the table, that backhand punch to the deep corner, and then the forehand the other way, coast to coast. Cruises her way back. Well, it was definitely tough work. I think Cruz implies a bit of relaxing here. Mima Chan, focused as can be, working hard for the points against world number one. Ball doesn't kick up so much. Stay on top. Keep the racket up. Just trying to interpret the body language there. 8 points each now.
9-8.
A bit of side spin, you could hear Ma Lin from the corner. Not only the coach for Chun Meng, but one of the most entertaining pen holders of all time. I think the other one you saw eliminated today in the semifinals by Liam Pitchford. Despite the banana split coming in, the follow-up shot carries just long. The topspin from Chun Meng protecting. And now two game points for Chun Meng. The kick serve. Chun Meng does the right thing to close the racket, but overcompensates just a bit. There's so much spin, and it's such a fast serve. I mean, you can understand why. We saw Feng Tianwei have that ball.
Timeout.
Timeout now. Yima Chun's second serve. Oh, just too strong. She returns the serve well, but the first attack, the third ball. Camera in camera action there. Mima Ito with the serves at the top of the screen. Trying to spin to the middle here. Not quite high enough for Mima smash as she stretches out the shoulder.
Let love.
25 years. The Qatar Open. I think 2009, in honor of Timo Boll's birthday versus Ma Lin, who's here coaching. I hope I've got that right. 2009 Qatar Open. Check it out on YouTube when the broadcast is done, but all the best table tennis right here, right now. Testing the wingspan, Chun Meng. She's just so free right now, Chun Meng. Really, a lot of racket speed to spin that ball right at the baseline. It's when someone gets a little bit hesitant, the ball doesn't get as much rotation, doesn't kick away from the net or put as much pressure on Mima Chun. That point, the side spin coming in. Whatever Mima Chun throws the other way, Chun Meng seems prepared for right now. A long chopping receive. I think that was the side spin one. Punches, and then caught in the middle in between.
Let la four.
Ooh.
La five.
It's funny, for a moment I thought it caught the back edge of the table, but no one else seemed to think so. I have the same view as you, so.
5-1.
First point for Mima Chun at the first towel break now. I get ahead of myself sometimes, thinking about the Olympic Games. A lot of conversation between the semifinals and now about what ifs, what are the chances for Mima Chun? Who will be sent for China? A lot of interesting conversations.
6-1.
Now, if you think of the three women that, for me, would be the front runners to campaign for their spot, Chun Meng, Liu Shiwen, the world champion, and Ding Ning, the defending gold medalist, the Queen of Hearts. Oh, right back, a little cat and mouse out here, back and forth, corner to corner. Mima takes her second point. Long serve, a step around to start nonetheless. Gets right back into position, controls with the backhand to the very corner. That's what it takes.
Let 2-6.
The knees.
2-7.
Just wanted to highlight that in case you didn't notice. Chun Meng on the receive. As I mentioned earlier, the way Mima Chun sort of shuffling to stay loose, get ready. They're changing it up for a bit. A different start to the point. Ooh.
8-2.
Another gift. This time on the tomahawk serve from the forehand side.
Eight, three.
pretty caution to the wind receive here. Sometimes when you're way down, you start taking different chances. Always looking for answers. It's the name of the game out here, even when you're down, especially when you're down. Oh, what a backhand, the angle. Mimichan moves in just a little bit, takes the ball early, and turns the racket to guide it out wide. Talking about wrist agility, flexibility out here. Mimichan staying loose. Now, from a physical fitness standpoint, I would say Chun Meng, no question, way physically stronger. Mima Ito, the looser player.
5-8.
More flexible, slightly less predictable. Because we're not using the multi-ball system, it was a bit shocking to see Chun Meng walk off like that, the way someone might for a timeout, just picking up the ball. Trying to add that extra pace to the ball, just long. It's a very fine margin for error. Right near that baseline is where Mimichan needs to keep it in these rallies. Unless Chun Meng gets way behind, or a step behind the table, and there's still an opportunity for short game. Strawberry, but the chop block does not connect. Chun Meng with 5 game points. Beautiful strawberry there. Doesn't miss this one by a lot, but Chun Meng not fazed by the side spin coming in.
Let him
interesting,
fight.
Interesting. For me, that makes quite a statement. The body language, even on a let service. Someone who's maybe at a loss right now for what to do.
16.
The placement on the push with the racket head straight up goes deep to the backhand corner and gets a point. Doesn't have to be glamorous, doesn't have to be the usual Mimichan style. A point is a point. Oyster shell reveal.
17.
Refusing to back up. Despite the ball coming in right at the baseline, Mimichan continues. 2 game points saved, still 3 to go for world number one. And the backhand goes out. It is a 3-1 lead. Chun Meng looking for her second platinum event. 2 for 2 this year. Beautiful opening. The backhand with the flat hit and then the forehand the opposite way with top and side spin. It's funny, we saw the same facial expression from Mima Ito after one of the best points from her in last game. It's how high the standards are. Doing amazing is simply expected. A lot of hard work here. Chun Meng straightening it up to go down the line. The very first ball that Mimichan plays was right at the baseline. A bit risky. Gets into the counters, but still more responsive. Once you let up just a little bit, she smashes.
Let one off.
Meaning you can't leave any loose balls for Mimichan. Forehand flick kill. This is something you would normally give to a taller player. I mean, you see a Matthias Falk playing a shot like this or a Dima, but Mima Ito, just above half that size, fast move, lunges in and still kills the ball. And the step around using the length of the table for security, a 3-1 lead. Still a long way to go, but a good start here. Now that's the bread and butter for Mima Ito. Floating around, stepping around the backhand corner for that snappy shot.
Let 1-3.
Right off the bounce, four. Controlling the heavy spin coming in. Mima Ito, Doing quite well to start off this game.
Let 1-4.
Behind the table in Nomima zone, trying, fighting to survive. Notice she doesn't get especially passive. She tries to punch back. She knows that if she plays slightly passive, Chun Meng has too much strength and control and time to really just spin the ball where she wants. We've seen Chun Meng against lobs this tournament, against fishing, fast-paced play, and little rotation smashes coming in. Too strong, surprise, surprise. It's coming right back to the backhand side, and now the timeout on Mima Chan's side. Going for broke down the line on the step around instead of using the length of the table, trying to play the parallel. A risky shot, but that's her game. Ito does risky, and she does it very well. She didn't take risks. She wouldn't be here now. I mean, to be a professional athlete, especially in a country where there's so much demand for this sport. Table tennis has more professional women in Japan. I mean, there are more professional women athletes playing table tennis in Japan than almost anywhere in the world.
4-6.
But the only place more, the place that China, excuse me, that Chun Meng is representing. Man, I spoiled that one. Anyway. Down by two. The Chinese women still leading the world. Mima Ito leading the Japanese women in the chase.
5-6.
It's a constant test for both. Now, if Chun Meng continues on to win this match, that will mean that the Chinese women have one of the three players I mentioned earlier who's undefeated against Mima Ito.
7-5.
And a lot of shuffles to get there for the backhand, but Chun Meng picking her placement well, testing the footwork, surprising Ito with the ball deep to the backhand.
Let 7-5.
Kieran lunging forward to play the ball from under the table. Chun Meng keeps so many in play to force Mima Ito to play this many balls that well. An inside-out forehand comes back. Takes all the pace off with the short pips. Just a block, nearly a drop shot from the baseline. Brings Mima Chan within 1 point. Placed right into that elbow, made it so uncomfortable, gave no place for any backswing on Mima Ito's side. Where to go from there? Chun Meng with the handcuffs from the backhand corner. Well, bobbing and weaving here. Coach Motz looking for answers as well. And this hooking forehand doesn't miss by a lot. If it comes down, it's going to be tough to reach. Chun Meng 2 points away from yet another title. Who knows how many more stops we'll have on the world tour before Olympic qualifications, before they're determined.
Let 6-9.
Still a lot up in the air right now with the state of things. And scraping the ball off the back edge, Chun Meng making a good opening here off a tough serve to receive. Practice partner for the Japanese team, former provincial player in China. Probably seen her from the days of Aichan, Kasumi Ishikawa, and Mima Ito. All the same, 4 championship points.
Let 10-6.
Cracking backhand to stay alive. One championship point saved. There's going to be a lot of work, a lot of thinking going on in the Mima Ito camp about how to get through Chun Meng if she doesn't take this match. Yeah! Forehand does it, wide out to the forehand side. Chun Meng.